Hi guys, welcome back. So today we are heading off to Dior, Prada, and I will see if I can vlog another store. Maybe Ferragamo. I know a lot of you have requested that you want to see some other brands. And so, of course, I will take you along with me. So in Dior, what I'm checking out is, they don't often have this, but they have a high jewelry event. And they have got jewels that are like special one-off pieces. So you don't often get to see these type of jewelry. So of course, I wanted to show you. Plus, I've got a couple of things on hold that I've just been thinking about from the Dior Riviera collection. So I will show you that as well. Not sure if I'm getting that yet. And then definitely want to head into Prada. I've been really impressed with Prada lately. I am actually going to be wearing my Prada headband today, and I'm still getting used to it, but I'm like, you know, it's worth trying out. It's very avant-garde, it's very full-on, but I think in black it's probably the most subtle out of all the colors. So if you love shopping vlogs, I think you're going to enjoy this video. So let's go. Put up with changes. Come pick me up, cause I just wanna see the light. I wanna be weightless. Teach me to fly, I won't be coming down. Could somebody wake me up? I don't wanna be here and let the world pass me by. Yeah. I just see your face where ever I look, she's standing in the crowd. So one necklace I had to try on, and it would probably be one of my favorites from the high jewelry collection, is this. It is called Cher, and it is super expensive. I believe it is about 880,000 Australian dollars. So it's not often that you get to wear such beautiful pieces. These are like one-off pieces, and it's just stunning. Like, wow. This is just definitely a wow necklace. Okay, so this is the Rose Devance choker, and this is definitely a stunning piece. This is around 85,000 Australian dollars, but is part of their high jewelry collection, and you actually can wear it the other way around as well. But I'm gonna try on the Masterpiece necklace. That one is a stunner, but I think it is maybe 128,000 Australian dollars, but very rare and just beautiful. Okay, so this is what it looks like on. This is the one that Cara Delevingne was wearing. It is called the Rose Devance Masterpiece Necklace, and rightly so. Look how stunning it is. It is definitely a statement piece, but there's only, I've been told, a few of them around. But if you're after a real statement piece, this is beautiful. Okay, let me show you. This is called the Archie Dior collection, part of their high jewelry as well. And this is the choker, and you can see it sort of resembles lace. Very ornate. This is also part of the collection. This is like a double ring. You can see floral through it. And then this is another piece from the Archie Dior collection, and this is supposed to resemble like rose petals. You know, Monsieur Dior, how he loved roses. I'll go into that. There's another whole collection that's, you know, very rose inspired. So let me show you some of the other fine jewelry pieces. I am going to get Trent, who is our expert here, to tell us what these are. So obviously I see some of these beautiful...
So these are the incredible diamond Dior timepieces.
Wow.
So ranging from having the sunshine on your wrist at this very first piece.
Wow. What stone
so
is
So these it? Are vivid yellow diamond yellow and white diamonds.
Okay.
Moving then into the middle watch, mm-hmm. that has, see that pink tone coming through.
It's so very it's a subtle.
Pink, a soft pink, yeah. and white diamond combination. Yeah.
Beautiful.
And then the full diamond experience.
Yes.
And full diamond timepiece. So the watch you wear when you're never in a hurry.
This is nice because it looks like a bracelet.
It goes all the way around. Mm. It is incredibly soft. So you can see how
Yes, it is. It's very...
it's so tactile, you just tactile. Almost want to play with it all day long.
Yes.
I mean, if you have diamonds, that, yeah. You want to play with it all day long. And then moving through into some of the incredible pink sapphires that are featured in the Dior high jewelry.
So you've got this little sweet ribbon and teardrop.
Yeah.
And
the incredible rings.
Wow.
This one here inspires me to think of a dress that is just sitting down, cascading out, with this incredible pink sapphire in the center.
Very, very pretty. And then this are just some
beautiful
droplets.
Drops. So again, the fabric that almost just drapes down.
Yeah, it's sort of like twirling around. Yeah. Around the.
And it gives it this illusion of movement.
It does. It does. Stunning. Okay, guys, let me show you an exceptional timepiece. Wow, look at this. So this is called the Grand Ball Watch, and it is, look at this. Can you see that sort of movement? What is that called? Like a feather movement?
So this is the oscillating weight. So this is what is quite incredible with the Dior Grand Ball.
With the Grand Ball, yeah.
Think back to Mr. Dior, and you imagine he has created a gown.
A ball gown.
A haute couture gown. And you are going to the grandest ball. This is the watch that is to be worn. So imagine the dress floating back and forward. That is what is special. And that is what the artisans in the Dior horological facilities in Switzerland have been able to do. So that oscillating weight, which you would normally find on the back of a watch,
is at the front,
is now being flipped to the front of it to create that almost ball gown movement that you can now experience.
Yes.
So it is actually a working piece, so it is an automatic movement. So that means the movement is created from the mechanism.
Yep.
And what it's doing, that oscillating weight, is creating the energy that keeps the movement going.
Okay.
So as you wear it, it's charging.
So if you wanted something really special, I didn't even know that Dior did. So this is the Grand Ball Personalization Marquetry Collection. So what this gives you the ability to do is that you can start to pick. So you can start with the cases. So they've got yellow gold, white gold, and rose gold. So once you've picked the case, then you can pick the oscillating weight. So there's ones with diamonds and ones with feathers, mother of pearl, lots of different combinations. And then next to it, you can pick the case back. As you know, Monsieur Dior was superstitious. So how cool is this? You can personalize the case back to your star sign. Once you've selected that, you can pick the dials. So look at how many options there are. So there's my favorite color, the malachite, tiger's eye, this beautiful pink mother of pearl. And that goes beautiful with this pink oscillating feather. And I love the feathers because you don't often see that. After that, you can pick your strap. So of course, the popular toile de jouy is gorgeous, or you can pick, for example, this pink alligator strap, which ties in beautifully with what we've got here. But if you wanted something dressier, you can pick the satin straps as well. There's an array of colors. And what I really love is that whatever strap you pick, you can actually purchase additional straps as well. So you can change up your look. And I think the beauty of this is because it is such a personal piece, this is definitely pricey, guys, but it's something that could become an heirloom. But just for, you know, all you watch lovers out there, it's good to know because you don't often get to see this, or I don't see it anyway, on other luxury channels. So of course I wanted to show you this. So we have another very special piece here. And what makes this piece so special?
So this particular piece is one of 18 pieces in the world.
In the world.
And this is actually number one of 18.
So you can see it marked one of 18 right there in the corner. Wow.
Again, the detail in this.
I'm just trying to zoom up and show, yeah.
Incredible. And that's what I love about high jewelry and high watches is the more you stare at them and the more you see and the more you look, and the more you discover about it, you know, and it's often, it's only for the wearer.
Oh, definitely.
You know,
it's just so much work. You can just see how much work is in there.
The 3D detail into it is exceptional.
So of course the center flower, because, you know, Monsieur Dior loved his flowers.
Right.
And then this sort of pave, is that pave?
Snow setting. Yes.
It does look like that. It's probably a lot harder than we imagine to embed all those in there.
Absolutely.
And yeah,
diamond encrusted.
And you can even just see just the little diamonds as, yeah, it is really 3D. I'm trying to show you guys from all angles. What a piece of art. Let me try this on. So this is got the emerald. This is all part of the high jewelry collection. Show you what this one looks like too. Check out some of these timepieces. That's very, very blinged up. And then this beautiful emerald one here too. Oh, that's emerald one. That's stunning. And then we've got the asymmetrical sort of, I don't even know the different cuts on that, but it's a lot of work. Let's move along. Oh, I need to show you this 8.8 carat tourmaline. Look at that. 8.8K. I mean, 8.8 carats. This is a huge stone. Absolutely beautiful. Let's move along to the rose collection. This is what I was talking about before, where, you know, roses play a big part in Monsieur Dior's inspiration. Roses was his favorite flower. So if you love roses, it definitely comes in the red, comes in the green as well, with and without the diamonds. All this with the roses. Completely, I don't even know what this application is called, but it's just completely paved, I guess. Is it paved? Looks like a garden. It's literally like a garden on your hand, wearing a garden on your hand. And then this one, if you show the double ring, this is, if you love color, that's very special. A bit too much for my liking, but these are all one of a kind pieces. And then I also love me a bit of ruby, and just look at this work. It is not easy to set all these diamonds in that swirl pattern. Look at all the baguettes. You can actually see to get all the baguettes around in that curved shape. You know, it is intricate work. You might not appreciate it, but a lot of work, a lot of detailing into that. Here is just another piece. And this one here, oh, I should show you. This one you can see, it's also roses, just sort of there. And these are just more of the high jewelry timepieces. Beautiful cases with all the jewels around it. And look at this dial. Very beautiful. What do you think, Ralphs?
I think it looks very impressive.
Okay, definitely one of the stars of the show is this amazing necklace. I think it's called the Dior Versailles necklace. This, guys, is $1.6 million. Look at that. So definitely a showstopper. I had to show you that piece as well. Okay, so I have to show you these tiny baby bags. Oh my goodness, are these not the most adorable things ever? So this is the baby 30 Montaigne. This is the little vanity. How cute is this little tinsy tiny nano Dior? Oh my goodness. Look, this is my hand. That's the size of it. So cute. Don't know how practical that would be. But how cute are they? Oh, I like that one too, the Caro. Sorry, that's the Caro. There. So this is the mini vanity in the lime. What do you guys think? I think this is $3,800 Australian dollars. So that is what it looks like on me. And then I'll just wear it crossbody for you. So that is what it looks like crossbody. So I do like the shoulder strap. Just not sure if I like the vanity better or should I get a small book tote. This is the Micro 30 Montaigne. How adorable is this? And for reference, this is the Micro Lady Dior. This is just too cute for words. It does actually take the artisans just as much time to create these miniature versions of the iconic bags. Oh my goodness, I am so tempted to get one. It definitely does not fit a phone, but I've been told these have been really popular, and in my local store, the Micro Lady Dior actually sold out, so that's why I can't show you it in this video. So this is the Micro Caro. This is super duper adorable as well. This might even look better as a waist belt, I think. Okay, so this is the lime green small book tote from the Dior Riviera collection. This was the one that I put on hold. Do you guys actually like this lime color better or the raspberry pinky red color? Wow, the red actually looks quite good on camera. Actually, probably looks more raspberry pink. So I'm just asking my essay, which one do you prefer? And he said lime. Okay, so lime or the raspberry pink? Comment below and let me know. So that is it for the video, guys. I hope you enjoyed coming along with me and checking out the exquisitely stunning high jewelry collection from Dior. It's not often you get to see these type of jewels. And also check out some of the cute new additions that Dior has at the moment. So if you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Stay tuned because next up, we are heading to Prada and Ferragamo. See you soon, guys. Bye.